deed, and we will answer, come home.
Thank you.
Church bells filled their midnight music, and the beasts listened. Yet they lay in their stalls like stone. Oh, the heretics! Not to remember Bethlehem, or the star as bright as the sun, or the child born on a bed of straw, to know only of the dissolving now. Still, they drowsed on, citizens of the pure, the physical world. They loomed in the dark, powerful of body, peaceful of mind, innocent of history. Brothers, I whispered, it is Christmas, and you are no heretics, but a miracle, immaculate still as when you thundered forth on the morning of creation. As for Bethlehem, that blazing star still sailed the dark, but only looked for me, caught in its light. Listening again to its story, I curled against some sleepy beast who nuzzled my hair as though I were a child and warned me the best it could all night.
Behold, the Lord's Supper. since the flight to Egypt, blooming indifferently, with lance-like leaf, green but silver underneath. Its flowers, white, originally, turned blue. The herb of memory, imitating the blue robe of Mary, is not too legendary. To flower both as simple and pungency, springing from stones beside the sea, the height of Christ when he was 33. It feeds on dew and to the bee, half a dumb language, is in reality a kind of Christmas tree.
Take a bend, the apple take a bend.